We will now return to your originally scheduled Minecraft versus program. It's been a while. We had a very, very long commercial break.
The longest of all time.
But we're back now. So
Oh
that's
man,
fun.
all my armor's broken. That's not good.
Yeah, it's a good time. It's been busy for all parties involved. But it's been fun.
Has it
Stuff has been
really?
going on, you know.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh, protection
Just mostly school
too.
stuff on my end, but some real life stuff too.
And
But we're back.
you know what they say, school is cool.
It is cool. It's the coolest form of school.
School cools. Squirrel
Yeah.
cools.
Very much, very cool.
So,
And I'm
Matt,
actually, yeah.
how was all the thing? How was your exams and stuff?
Well, I have two more tomorrow, but
Oh,
I'm not
what?
worried about any of them,
Okay, that's good. I
so
was gonna
that's
say
why
you
I'm
should not
here.
be here.
Yeah, and I'm not worried about either of them. One of them is because I'm a journalism major and a music minor, so one of them is a journalism test,
Oh.
which I'm not worried about because the bulk of the grade was a 25-page paper, which I handed in today. The test isn't that big of a deal.
Holy
It's just a
crap.
little bit of basic statistics, pretty much. And like everyone in the class freaked out because they're like, "No, I came into journalism to not do math." And I was like,
Wait,
"I mean, I hate
really?
math as much as the next guy, but basic statistics is not something to be afraid of."
I took a statistics. That was the math class I took in university, and I maybe it's because I didn't take any statistics at all in high school, so I had no idea what was going on from day one. Talking
Right,
about all these
right.
like functions, like I don't know what this means, and then I stopped
Yeah,
going to
but the thing is,
university.
if we're not talking about like advanced statistics either. Like we're talking like mean, median, mode, range, variance.
Oh yeah, okay,
Like
yeah, that stuff I recognize all those words, and that's a good sign.
Yeah, exactly. Like it's not super difficult. So like, you know, especially since he said he would give us the formula for like variance on the test. I'm like, well, then there's no excuse. I am gonna drain out this pick if I use this strategy. And
Be careful, don't get stuck.
I've been in this nether for so long, like, 'cause I haven't played the game since the last time that I barely remember the way back,
Your
right?
character
So
has
it's
literally
like
been sitting there for months.
literally,
Or a
yeah.
month in
He's
a
been
bit.
starving. I mean, not really starving, but like, you know, theoretically starving.
You're a very skinny Tetris block.
Yeah, very skinny Tetris block. I'm the long four piece of Tetris blocks.
You're like half a pixel now and wide instead of a full pixel
Yes.
wide. So, Matt, what is your opinion on Luigi boards?
Luigi boards?
Squish boards.
Waluigi boards.
Waluigi. Exactly.
Yo, I
Those
love
ones.
Waluigi. He's like my favorite character.
I thought Wario was your favorite. I'm gonna tell him you're cheating on him. How
No,
dare you?
Waluigi's always been better than Wario, dude. Always. I mean, I love Wario games, but
Yeah.
Waluigi doesn't have any games, so I mean, if there was a
It's true.
Waluigi game, definitely would be better than any other Wario
There
game.
needs to be a Waluigi game, is what I've learned today.
Well, I think there actually is like a Waluigi fan game. I've just never had
Oh,
the
a
time
fan game. I
to
was gonna say, I'm
play it.
pretty sure there hasn't been a
But
Waluigi game
I've
yet.
heard great things about it, so. Okay. Well, this is the wrong direction. We need to go this way. Okay.
But yeah,
So
so
Ouija boards. Let's
yeah.
hear it.
Okay, so I went to this. It wasn't really a party or anything. It was more just a thing was set up where my girlfriend and all of her friends they were gonna have like a little game night. And partway through
Okay.
the game night, they're like, "Oh, I brought a Luigi board," and my girlfriend is absolutely horrified of a Ouija board. She immediately noped the hell out of there. And I don't particularly put too much stock in spoopy ghosts are real. I mean, I do. I would never go mess around in a graveyard or anything. And I thought I would never want to play a Ouija board, but I was like, yeah, sure, why not? There's a bunch of people here. It's not my house. Why not? I'm not afraid of no spoops. And
Right.
it was weird at first because no one really knew what we were doing, and a lot of like there was like there's like 7 or 8 of us all have our grubby little fingers on this stupid little piece for that moves around on the Ouija board. and nothing was happening, obviously. And I know how it works. Mostly it's like, you know, one person twitches a little bit and then you just kind of follow the momentum. I immediately tried to like mess with that because nothing happened for the first like 15, 20 seconds of dead silence of people trying to ask questions and then nothing happening. So I tried to like kind of nudge it a bit just to kind of, you know, get something to happen.
Right.
And it is surprisingly very difficult unless like everyone's like kind of subconsciously cooperating to move that thing. Like I was putting a lot of pressure on it and it was not budging. And eventually it did start moving. And one of the rules, because we did look up rules afterwards, like see like, oh, maybe this, like, we got to do this differently. And one of the rules was if it starts counting down from 9 to 0, or if it starts going from Z to A, you have to say goodbye and leave it immediately. Otherwise, you'll be spooped forever. And okay. So we asked like that eventually happened, and then everyone was like, no, and they had to say goodbye. I really wanted it to go to 0 though, just to mess around more. But one of the questions was, are you Satan? And it was really weird too, because the person that really wanted to play the Ouija board the most was she's the daughter of a priest.
Oh, that's funny.
And she is the one that we designated to ask its questions, and we asked if it was Satan. It said it was Satan. It said there was 5 ghosts in the house. And it was my girlfriend that like got the hell out of there immediately and waited outside till we were done, and like another person that left. And otherwise, yeah, nothing super eventful happened. Some guy put on spoopy music in the background. But it was generally a good time.
That's funny.
And that's my not it's super eventful Luigi story, minus the fact that, you know, it started counting from 9 to 0.
But that could have been just because someone was like, I'm done, like, I don't want to do this anymore, you know?
Yeah.
Well, and you have no way, there's no way you can know.
Definitely, and yeah, like I said, I do know, like, how, like, it's pretty easy to, like, manipulate it. But like I said, like, I don't know if it maybe just the friction changed over time. Like, even as it was moving, I was still trying to, like, kind of move it to answer it, like, you know, say Satan was here or something, like, general, like, stupid stuff like that, just to try and scare some of the more easily scared, I suppose. And yeah, so I don't know, it was interesting to say the least.
That's quite an experience. I can't say I've ever done that.
Nah.
Damn.
I ain't afraid of ghosts.
Never done that. Although one of my friends has like a Ouija board shot glass, and I'm like, well, you can't like do the Ouija board on the shot glass, so is it just like for aesthetic appeal? Like, I wouldn't spend that much money on a Ouija board shot glass, but like, I guess that's up to you, I guess, you know.
Whenever they take like a drink, they get possessed.
Drink alcohol, get possessed. that's how it works. Okay, well, I'm on my last iron pick. So that's a good time.
Nope.
There's
no. Are you just digging? Are you digging straight to the
No,
quartz?
I was. I'm descending at this point because I'm like heading to a different sort of region. I'm at like the 400x mark, but I need to go like way up in the Z area because the Z you said was double the X. So,
yes. Roughly.
Yeah. So that's where I'm at. I don't. We'll see what happens.
Magic will happen.
There's some weird noise going outside, but I'm not shutting that window. I don't care. It's too damn hot.
It's too damn hot outside. Oof. My armor is all broken.
Now I need to go up here. The good news is that now that like I found open spaces, I don't have many picks, but I do have a crap ton of netherrack. So
so you could stack up to your heart's content.
Yeah, pretty much. As long as I have a way down. Which I do at this point. So
I don't remember how many ender eyes I need. That's kind of an issue.
Well, the maximum you the maximum it's amount 9, you would need, right?
Yeah, I think the max I could get is 9. I have 5 right now. I think I need 8, maybe.
I remember you saying it was a lot.
Yeah, I think there was only 1 in there when I first started, but Oh crap, right, but I needed the ender eyes to find the space, so
Well, I guess I'm bridging over here. I'm gonna head back a completely different way probably. Because I'm just gonna have to use coordinates at this point. Because the other thing I don't have is torches.
Yeah. Well, you don't really need torches in
You don't really. I just use them the same way I would use them in, like, a cave for navigation
purposes. Oh, right, right, right.
But I don't have anything too particularly valuable either because of my last lava-related death.
Yeah. There's a skellyman. Come, Mr.
So, I haven't announced this on, like, Twitter or anything like that, but I will.
Getting the scoop.
But part of the reason I was really excited to get back to this is because I'm actually working on a scripted thing about Minecraft. So that'll be interesting. Obviously I need to like play the game in order to like have that experience.
Get sniped on, witch.
So I'll probably at some point start a new single player thingamajig.
A single
because a lot of what I'm talking about in the script is the early game.
This witch dropped a stack of bottles. What looked like a stack of bottles, or at least like you know more than one, it just turned out to be empty glasses.
You get
potions from them.
I was hoping it was Bottles the Mole.
No, not that. That Banjo-Kazooie.
Have you played Yooka-Laylee?
Yeah, I've streamed it a couple times. I've been generally super frustrated about it so far. But that might also
That's the thing. It's like there's some missions that are like really frustrating and like badly made. Mm-hmm. But then there are other parts of the game that I'm like, wow, this is really good.
I haven't really hit any of the really good parts yet, but I'm waiting to get a controller. I actually ordered.
That'd be a reason is PC controls.
Yeah. Oh, definitely. Yeah. Oh my god, I'm gonna die here. The PC controls are pretty garbage. I've been. I ordered a Nintendo. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. I've ordered a Nintendo Switch controller, like a Pro controller, because I'm really used to like Nintendo stuff. So that's why I was like, yeah, this will be perfect.
Is it automatically compatible with PC?
Yeah, it actually is. The thing is,
that's a first.
Yeah, Same thing with the Switch, the Joy-Cons. It's also compatible with that. Oh my god, creeper!
Really? Are they compatible like together, or is it like only separate?
I'm not entirely sure how it works because my computer turns out does not have Bluetooth capability. So I also had to order a dongle. And it turns out that the dongle I ordered does not really work properly or something. I spent freaking like probably 4 or 5 hours trying to get that thing to work. Get my controller to connect. It absolutely refuses to connect to my computer. So spent like $80 on that stupid thing. It doesn't even work for my computer.
Wow.
So that sucks. So I ordered an Xbox One controller two nights ago, actually. So I'm praying that will work for me, because if not, that is going to be a pain in the butthole. Why are there so many zombies? I want y'all to leave me alone. Oh my god.
Leave me alone.
So that's been my fun technical issues on every single aspect in the universe. Oh my god, there's a freaking million zombies here. I need you all to leave me alone.
I haven't had any technical issues, I've just had copyright issues.
Yep.
That's the funny thing about the Viacom thing that I never mentioned is because throughout this semester I've been applying to like intern places, right? Mm-hmm. And you know, nothing really panned out because I'm not your traditional journalism student.
Yeah.
Which is fine. You know, whatever. I'll figure things out. But one of the places I applied to was actually at Viacom.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Because I figured. I have a lot of like television experience because of like my experience on the college's TV station, so I was like, oh, maybe that'll work out. So I actually applied to work at Viacom, and then they repay me by copyright claiming my video.
Now, if they now, let's say they emailed you or called you or whatever right now and said, hey, we have a job for you, would you accept that job?
I would ask them.
Because for those that don't know, Matt just posted a video recently. It got taken down by
Yeah, it was a South Park video. It was taken down. But it doesn't surprise me. It was Content ID claimed, and Viacom is an automatic system. And Viacom was one of the companies responsible, basically, for Content ID's existence.
Right, yeah.
They sued YouTube, right? So it doesn't surprise me. But,
Too bad.
So I guess I would be like, yes, but I would also want to, like, solve that problem. And maybe working there, where I could talk to people and then, like, get the problem solved.
Yeah, maybe.
So the thing is
oh
like,
my God.
There are things you can blame Viacom for, right? Like, I can blame Viacom for denying my appeal, right? Because if I appeal it and they're like, oh, we were wrong, then that's fine. But, like, they didn't. They took the time to look at that request and say no.
Nobby.
So that's something I can blame them for, but I can't blame them for the claim existing in the first place, because that's a YouTube system thing.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a system which learns over time, and learning fair use when most human beings don't know and understand fair use, well, that's like hard for a computer to do. So
true dat, son, true dat. Oh my God, there's so many monsters out here, not a single Enderman, not a single one.
So, like, a lot of people were like, well, I don't understand how people can upload, like, full clips of the show, and then your video is the one that gets claimed. Well, it's not like Viacom's like, no, I want to pick on this guy.
Mm-hmm.
It's just the system and how it works, which sucks, but it is what it is.
Unfortunately. Man.
So I figure this is, like, somewhat relevant. Because when we did the Revenge of the Flying Dutchman versus, you linked me to Lamhoot, right?
Oh, right.
He did the Revenge of the Flying Dutchman video where he said that because of the jellyfishing contest, like, the entire game was terrible, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he recently, like, closed out his SpongeBob quadrilogy, if you will, and reviewed the movie game. So now all three games that we versus, he has looked at, and he only likes Battle for Bikini Bottom.
Yeah, I didn't realize that was his first time playing the movie video game. But yeah, I could definitely understand why someone would not particularly enjoy that game.
I think the thing is, and I didn't really think about this until, like, after his video was posted, because I did a Let's Play. Back when I Let's Played, I Let's Played Pac-Man World 2, and I loved that game as a kid. Like, that was, like, one of my favorite games as a kid.
Uh-huh.
And so when I said I was going to Let's Play it, I said I was going to play through the game three different times with three different approaches, basically, because I was, like, super progressive Let's Player or whatever. And so the first playthrough was just going to be, like, a playthrough to introduce everyone to, like, the levels and stuff like that. The second one was going to be the time trials, and the third one was going to be 100% collect all the fruit and everything, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I only did the first one because I hated the game. Like, I didn't like it anymore. I acted in the Let's Play like I liked it, but there are some levels that are just really terrible. And I didn't realize that at the time, but, like, you know, I still have fun. I still revisit the game. I still play the good levels that I enjoy because I still enjoy the game. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's a pretty bad game,
yeah. All
things considered. So I think there's an element where it's like the movie game I knew had its problems, but I always have had fun playing it. So it's like, well, I just kind of, like, it didn't matter, you know?
Mm-hmm. Oh, my God, I hate Endermen so much. Why are they designed this way? They teleport whenever you try to swing at them. Why? Oh, my God. Sorry, I'm so... suck to deal with.
There's gonna be so many lava bridges. Oh my God. Oh my, the lava bridges. There's so many. Luckily there are no ghasts or anything, nothing's shooting at me, so
yes. No, you jinxed it. You're screwed.
Huh. I jinxed it. I made a reaction video. comedy.
Oh my God.
What's our time looking like?
We're at 18 and a half minutes. There we go. You better. He didn't. Oh, he jumped too. I think I have enough Ender Pearls now.
Oh, snap. We're coming close to the end.
I don't know where my house is, though.
Remember when you said that the Versus was going to be shorter than, like, all the other ones?
Yeah, I do. That's because I've seen videos of people rushing the Ender Dragon, even not, like, you know, speedrunning tactics, but just, like, you know, normal scrubs. Like, UHC... So you could beat the dragon first, and within 2 hours, normally you'd be dead. But then again, I guess they were in, like, a team.
Yeah.
And we're single players plus... I mean, I guess I can't speak for you, but I certainly suck, and I'm probably going to die to the Ender Dragon.
But we shall see. I've never fought the Ender Dragon, so I don't think I would be good at fighting the Ender Dragon.
That's true, yes. And I've only fought him in teams. I think I might have actually just randomly tried fighting him, like, I don't know, like, a couple months ago. But... Oh, I did solo him once, actually, on the Unoriginal Craft server. And I was in full diamond armor, and I was still horrified, so I'm sure this will go well.
Then there will be the credits episode, where we just sit
or you watch.
watch the credits because they're so long.
A million years. Okay, do I have enough is the real question. I have, ooh, I better have
the thing
powder.
is that credit sequence, if you haven't seen it, like, look online for it, because it's probably like the most appropriate credits for that game, for this game, you know.
Yeah,
and like, it's long and it tells a story and all this crazy stuff, but it's like that might be like the best thing in this game. Like, I'm not even kidding.
I like that much, hey?
Because I think it fits it so well. You know, I could go into like the problems with Minecraft, but like, I'm going to, because I'm making a video about that.
And what do you mean, Minecraft best game 2017?
It came out in 2011.
2017, 6 years. Wow, it almost feels like it's been out much longer and also much shorter than that.
Well, because the beta came out, the alpha came out in 2009, 2008.
All right. Oh, okay. That was the full release. Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
The full release was 2011.
Right. Okay.
And that was when we got the end and the Ender Dragon and all that.
Really? Okay. Yeah, that sounds much more right. The good old days when it first came out. Nostalgia. Okay,
I'm sort of directionally challenged and I need to figure out where I actually need to go. So that's going, I'm facing positive Z, positive X. So I need to keep going across. Okay.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I don't know why that song's in my head. Okay, I think I'll need one more night and I think I'll have enough stuff to go fight.
And then you go back and you find out that you don't.
Yeah, that sounds like something that would happen to me. I do need glowstone. I need, what do I need? I would like some more levels to enchant stuff. Maybe I could do books. That sounds like a great idea. Yeah.
Still need to edit that 3D world race.
I forgot about that. I think I saw footage for that. Did I give
I have everything, I'm fairly certain. I put none of it on the hard drive that like I couldn't access anymore. Like, none of the footage is on that. It's all on my editing hard drive. So,
I have a notch apple.
Oh, you do?
I didn't even realize I had that.
That's awesome.
That is going to make that fight much easier, to be honest.
Yeah.
Depstra, I don't want that crap.
Ooh, it's a lava pit. Don't want to fall into the lava pit. I might not be able to like make it all the way over, because there's I'm bridging so much. How many did you remember having the like lava bridge a lot?
A fair amount.
Okay, well, I have like 4 stacks left, but then I'd have to dig up more, and then I'd probably use up the iron pick. So.
I'm breaking one. No, I don't care.
Funny joke.
Funny joke. Yeah, that's a good one. That's a good meme. I'm gonna probably need more iron too. Wow, I need so many things and stuff.
And stuff and things.
I need stick. Hello, stick. Oh, we're at like 24 minutes, by the way. We should probably end it.
Yeah, let's do that.
Goodbye, everybody. I hope you die.
Peace out.
Bye.
Ugh.